Welcome back. In all these cases up to now, we've assumed that we know the population parameters, mu and sigma, but much of the time we don't. We often only have samples, which we must then use to draw all our conclusions. In the next two lessons, we'll use samples to find out how different a sample mean is from a population, and how different two samples are from each other. Out of all the measures of center, we usually use the mean. Now, the two samples we're comparing in this case can either be dependent or independent. We'll go over these differences later. In lesson 10, we're going to look at these. And then in lesson 11, we'll look at independent samples. It's going to be fun! When we work with samples, we have to estimate the population standard deviation using the sample standard deviation with Bessel's correction. Remember this from lesson 4? Normally, to find out how typical or atypical a sample mean is, and what you did before, is we would find its location on the distribution of sample means, the sampling distribution. And we can determine the shape and parameters of this sampling distribution if we know the population parameters. Remember that for any sample mean, we can find where it falls on this distribution by standardizing. In other words, finding the z-score of the sample mean. We find the difference between the sample mean and mu, and then divide by the standard error. But now, the standard error depends on the sample. We can no longer use sigma if we have a sample. Therefore, we end up with a new distribution that is more prone to error. This is called the t-distribution. Since it's more prone to error, then it's more spread out and thicker in the tails than a normal distribution. Remember from lesson 7 when you learned that larger sample sizes result in skinnier sampling distributions? That same principle applies here. So what do you think happens as n, the sample size, increases? The standard error increases? The t-distribution approaches a normal distribution? The t-distribution gets skinnier tails? And finally, s, the sample standard deviation, approaches sigma.